Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. Artcast probably 307, maybe 308.5, I'm not quite sure. Somewhere around there. Well, I'm just taping this piece back down. I had to scan it, so I untaped it. And it's because I needed to cut some mats. So I got my piece of paper that I'll cut out the mats from. I just print that out rather than using like Frisket or something. But yeah, I want to do an art cast because I've been neglecting them, and I might just do this one just as a Patreon exclusive because I know I haven't been doing much for you guys lately. But I'm trying to decide on the color I'm going to do this piece. I did a couple color roughs, which this is actually another, just a couple copies I made. And I just laid in some color with a brush. And at first I was kind of leaning towards this one with like a red moon. After the art cast, I kind of asked Kevin and Scott which ones they liked both. And they both picked different ones, but now I'm kind of like, I took a little bit of time to think about it, and I'm sort of leaning towards this one with the color faces. And then what I'm thinking is actually make Dracula, like, because I want to have a part of it sort of just in blue, so he's kind of cast like, you know, has that kind of cast that like the movie has, like an old black and white photo. But I think what I'm going to do is actually not do the red moon, and I'm going to just do a blue moon, so it's all just kind of one thing. And you know, the only things I'll color is just like the white, you know, just do it like a black and white drawing. I'm not quite sure yet. I'm just gonna see how this all works, and you guys can hang out with me while I airbrush this thing. So when I cut out the mats, I just use my knife, and this is, I actually printed this on the back of one of my prints that messed up. I see it ran out of ink. So this paper was just blown. And this is going to be cut into three sections. So like one for the top figure, one for her, and one for him. And these two will probably be kind of, you know, probably like let some spill kind of get on this guy. Because I'm going to have a little bit of flesh on him too. I want to make him very pale. I don't want him to be like, you know, skin color, of course. Even though I think that, you know, there's, it's kind of interesting. Like when I was looking around for reference for Dracula, what I found was some colorized versions of Dracula. And in the colorized versions, he's actually like just normal skin color, which is, I don't like, you know. I don't like the look of that. And then I don't know if it's just like, you know, if that's actually how he was, or the colorization process is just kind of messed up. But I want to make my Dracula pale. It might be something kind of like the Frankenstein. You know, like with the Frankenstein movie. I know like the movie poster artist painted Frankenstein green, so everybody assumed he was green because the first, you know, the original movie was in black and white. But he was actually pale. He was actually, like, white. Or gray. And I guess that could have been what happened with Dracula, too. But to me, you know, vampires need to be pale, so I just don't think he would be as scary if I painted him, like, skin tone or something. My friend Sean Tiffany, I think I've probably said this before in my videos, but he was the one who showed me this idea of cutting out mats from just copies, which I don't really use very tight mats. This isn't a very good way to do like really nice tight mats. If I did wanted to do that, I'd use Frisket, cut them that way, but a nice way to kind of get couple fast mats that you could shoot over just like real quickly. Thought I'd show you this too. Another trick I do, like when I do these mats, I just put a piece of tape up there like that, and then I just stick them in like this, so they, you know, all stay in the same place. When I need them, I can just reach up there, you know, pop them out like that. It's not a big deal with this one, like three mats, but like, you know, sometimes if I'm doing like a piece, like that Captain America piece, actually it's right here. You know, like this one's like quite a bit smaller and had like quite a few mats, you know, like there was one cut like here, and there was one cut for his face, and, you know, a cut for the belt, because there's like a lot of, you know, opposing colors or whatever you want to call them, just all over this piece. So I like how this one came out. It came out pretty good. When I painted this one, I was like, no more big pieces. But then, I don't know, I like doing a little bit bigger pieces, so this one's semi-big. Okay, so here we go. Gonna do her face first. Kind of start with the, like I usually just go down the color wheel, basically. So I go yellow, and then I do like the browns or reds, and then I do the blues. So, kind of how I do it. So her hair is yellow, and plus I want a lot of yellow on her face. So I'm just gonna kind of, I just cleaned my airbrush, so it's really spraying heavy. Use this card to kind of blast that bit off there. I know, like when whenever I airbrush, everybody who actually airbrushes always has a fit about the way I do it, because I do it all wrong. But that's how I like to do it, so that's how I do it. I'm not trying to freaking be an airbrush artist, you know. The airbrush is just, I don't know, it's just something I started using, so I could just do the stuff with a brush if I needed to. I sprayed her face yellow, more yellow on the hair. Now I need to kind of mask the hair out. I'm going to put some like burnt sienna on the face. I want her to have really blonde hair, like really glowy blonde hair, so I kind of shot it pretty blonde at this point, and then as I paint it, of course it'll get more blonde. Paint some. I need to tape this on for a second so I can hold it down. I need to use my both hands. Move that a little bit. I need that card which I dropped. There it is. I can get this tightened down enough. I can shoot a little bit small with it right now. Think about when I clean it, it's kind of like, you know, so old that it doesn't ever, just won't like shoot paint. Like usually I could, you know, if this was newer or a little bit dirtier, but I could get it down to where it's not shooting any paint. It just wants to really shoot a lot of paint because I just cleaned it out. I'm gonna drop some out of the cup. Okay, so that's kind of where I'm at. I sprayed her face mainly reddish, you know, brown. A lot of times I say red when I mean brown, because I don't really like brown brown. I usually go for a reddish brown. Now with him, I'm just going to airbrush in, like when I'm planning. I mean, I'm almost like talking to myself because I'm trying to plan it out in my mind. But what I want to do is actually, I want to, you know, just some of the shadows in his face, like, or not even the shadows, but just the darker areas in the face. I actually want to just hit it with flesh tone. And then I want to hit the rest of his face with blue. So then when I come back with the white, you know, where I go over it with the blue, it's going to take on that blue tone. Where I go over it with the kind of the tans and stuff, it's going to take on that tone. And then there's a little bit of yellow here and there. And I want that to be kind of like patches of green. I'm not quite sure I'm going to get that with the airbrush, but I'm going to try that with the color pencils. I'm trying to give him like a white face that somehow is different than like what this figure and stuff is going to be. This whole thing's going to be a lot more to the blues. No browns, no yellows, anything like that. It's just going to be very monotone. But, you know, like his face, I want it to have color. But I also want it to look, you know, pasty white, like cake makeup kind of stuff. So, alright, so there it is. New mask. Let's put that over the top. I'm just going to lay it in where I think it should go. I think that's like it. This one right here. And we'll just see if it works. Let the hair dry for a second. Let me see, I actually want her tape being real solid, because I don't want any of this glue getting down on her, so I'm going to tape this one to the board in here. That would just be a real drag and really hard to fix if I kind of contaminate any of the nice yellows and golds with blue. It's kind of funny, like airbrushing really is, you know, it's so foreign to like the way like I paint and draw, or have always painted and draw, because I'm not like a guy who kind of, you know, I always kind of just go everything by the gut, you know what I mean? I don't really ever go like, okay, this is a step one, this is step two, this is step whatever, 16. I kind of just start where I want. And I paint what I want, and I probably paint the wrong thing first, and I concentrate on the detail, but you know, it works for me. It's like the way I do it. Let's see what this looks like. But with airbrushing, you know, it's a lot more technical, I think. Or something like that. You know, it's like you gotta kind of plan and think things out a little bit more. And it's just foreign to like, the way I paint. Let's throw a little on here and see what happens. I darked him up quite a bit. I think it's going to be fine. So the white's going to bring him back, too. Let's take a look, see what this looks like. Looks good. I actually like it. I'm gonna dry it off and figure out what I'm gonna shoot next. So I'm actually pretty happy with the way that looks. It's not everything I want, but it's like, I think it's a good base color. I mean, that's all I try to do with my airbrush is just get local color. That's my thing, you know. That's like my style with an airbrush, I guess you could say. So I'm just gonna button these back up. And then just shoot this top part. I'll just stick that down with one of these underneath here. And he probably would look fine without a mask, but I'm just gonna stick one on like this. Just to sort of separate it. I'm gonna go pretty blue with it. Kind of soak it down. I'm gonna soak the moon too, says that's gonna be all just painted with a texture really. So it's just gonna be me like dry brushing on top and wiping away and stuff like that. I built up the texture with it's getting kinda wet, better dry it out. I built up the texture with drywall with a gesso and modeling paste. So there it is. It's kind of like where I'm at right now. Just took the camera off the tripod so you guys could see better. But I think it's a good basis. I go on there with my color pencils and start fixing stuff, accentuating certain things. Bringing out the colors I like and getting rid of the colors I don't. I'm just kind of sitting over here because I'm looking up. Gonna buy a new battery for my camera off of eBay. These are like the little batteries I use for my Canon PowerShot, which is the camera I've been filming with lately. And it just seems like they run out of juice like so quick. So I thought, I bought this camera used off eBay, so I was thinking maybe the batteries are actually shot and I just need a couple new ones. So I'd look it up and order a couple off my favorite shopping site, eBay. I think that's probably it for the video. I didn't really have much to say today. I just thought I need to make a video. I don't know. I'm really debating whether I put this one just straight onto Patreon and not do a YouTube, Just like make it unlisted, because part of like the thing with that is I just feel like I should do that for my Patreon people because they give me money. I need to give them something back, but then I don't know. Every time I start doing that, then I kind of start regretting it and thinking like, oh no, I'll just put it out to the world, But lately I've just, it's just hard to make videos sometimes. I feel for people who say they can't make videos, because every time I kind of stop making videos for a while, I come back and I'm like, it's almost like, maybe like a confidence thing or something, but it's just like I feel unconfident about making videos, But then I think, no, you need to make videos. You're the guy who makes videos. You gotta keep doing it. But, yeah, it's just, I don't know. I mean, I get tired of, like, trolls and bullshit like that, but that's not that big a deal, I get trolled on, like, DeviantArt, and I don't care, I don't know why it makes a difference on YouTube, but I don't know. Anyway, I guess this video will be up. Maybe it'll be on YouTube, maybe not, who knows? And, if it is on YouTube, maybe go check out Patreon. And comment, subscribe. I don't know. Why do I even say that? Like, comment, subscribe. Just because everybody else says it. I think I'm just going to quit saying that. See you guys next time.